Hi, it's Tracy again, and today I'm going to show you how to play a song called My Eyes by Blake Shelton. And don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment, especially if there is a particular song that you would like to learn. Put the name of the song down there and I'll try to get to it. Also, you can find some cool stuff if you visit my website at tracysmithmusic.com. And I'm going to show you how to play this song a couple of different ways today, one without a capo. And one with the capo on the second fret. So let's zoom in and get started. All right, the song starts with the intro, and we're going to play octaves against the open E string here. It's going to start with my first finger on the fifth string on the ninth fret, and my third finger on the third string on the 11th fret, and I'm going to mute with my first finger the fourth string. So we end up with playing that note, muting that note, playing that note against the open E. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take that formation and we're going to slide it, strike it and slide it up to where our first finger's now on the 11th fret. And then we're going to come back to the ninth fret with our first string, and then down to the seventh fret. So it's the same position, we're just moving it around. And it's going to sound like this. That's the first half of it. You can check what my right hand is doing here. I'm going to do it slow. All the time we've got the low E string underneath it. That gives us some warmth and really makes it a nice warm sound when we're doing that instead of just playing the two notes together. Just helps to have that note down there. Makes it sound cool. Okay, the second half of that starts the same as the first, but ends early. So we've got is the second half, same frets, but we're ending early. So the whole intro okay, that intro happens twice at the beginning, and then it's going to happen again sporadically through the song. Let's go ahead and focus on the end of the guitar and talk about the chords in the verse and chorus. All right, for chords, without the capo, we're going to do an E. We're going to do an F sharp minor 7, and we're going to do an A. You can play this way, or if you like, it's just a matter of picking up your thumb from the F sharp minor 7. Now, I'm assuming that most everybody knows their E chord already and their A chord. But this F sharp minor 7, there's a couple of different ways to play it. The way I play it is to bring my thumb over the top and hook and pull at the second fret, and then bar the bottom four with my second finger. While I'm muting with the tip of that finger and my thumb, I'm muting the fifth string so that we don't hear it. In the case of the F sharp minor 7, we can do that, and if it's open, it's no big deal. It doesn't hurt anything, but if we use this as the G sharp minor 7 that we're going to do in a little bit, then we absolutely have to mute that or it'll be a bad note. Okay? So we're going to have two measures of E. F sharp to a minor 7. A. And then repeat. Now that's the chords for the verse and for the chorus. Each time. So two measures of E, one measure of F sharp minor 7, and a measure of A. Now, what I'm doing for a pattern here with my right hand is I'm just going tick, tick, strum, 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 tick, tick, strum. Now I'm picking the fifth string. I'm adding just a little uptick right before I go back and do the first part of the pick there, just to make it a little more interesting. And those are the chords for the verse and for the chorus. And the verse, the first time, it's verse two times, and then there's chorus, and you do that two times. And then you go back and do the intro again, which we already covered. And then you're going to do a verse again, which you're only going to do it one time this time. Then go to another chorus two times through that, and then you're going to do the intro, just the first half of the intro, and then you go into the bridge. Now the bridge is going to use your F sharp minor 7 for a measure. You're going to slide that formation up to the fourth fret for a G sharp minor 7. Then you're going to go to an A for a measure, and then a B for a measure, which you can play the bar chord B this way. First finger, third finger, third finger, third finger, muting the outside two strings, the first and the sixth. Or you could, if you wanted, add the seventh to that and play a B dominant 7 would work there as well, and that's second finger on the second fret of the fifth string, first finger on the first fret of the fourth string, third finger on the second fret of the third string, and your pinky underneath here on the second fret, first string, and not playing the sixth. We're avoiding it or muting it with a little bit of our finger getting over there against the sixth string. Okay, so the bridge is going to sound like this. We just strum and hold on the B, or strum and hold on the B7 if you prefer that sound. And then you're going to do a chorus again and repeat the chorus, and then you're going to do the intro to end. Okay, so I'm going to get a capo on and show you how to do it now with the capo. Okay, so now I have my capo on the second fret, and I'm going to be starting instead of with an E now, we're going to use a D chord, but for the intro, we're going to play it a little bit differently because we want to play this lead line. We're going to play that intro that way. So it's second fret on the fourth string to the fourth fret on the fourth string. And back to the second to open. But we're going to add this partial D chord above that with the second and third strings there. Okay? So I'm going to play that beginning, I'm going to bar these two with my first finger, and I'm going to hammer with my third finger onto the fourth fret. And then I pull that off to allow the open string. Like so. It's a little bit more difficult, I think, to do the intro this way than with the open strings, but some of the chords are easier this way. So again, the intro. Like so, and you're going to do that twice. Now, the chords, in this key are going to be D. Then you do E minor to G. So you've got two measures of D. E minor. G. And that's your chord progression for your verses and choruses. And of course the form is the same, so when you need to go back and do the intro, you do that in those places. The bridge chords with this capo on, we're going to start with, on the bridge, E minor. Then we go to F sharp minor 7. And then we go to G. And then to A. So, again, for the bridge, E minor, F sharp minor 7, G, A strum, and then you're back to the chorus. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope that helps you with the song. And don't forget to check back fairly often. To see if there's any new guitar videos up for you. And thanks all of you who have subscribed. I've gotten quite a few more subscribers over the last few months, and I sure do appreciate that. And I'll be trying to get some more videos up for you all pretty soon.